For this holy sacrifice of the Mass for the eternal rest of Charles and Mary Kinmont. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord. Show us, O Lord, your mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Let us pray. Grant Almighty and merciful God, that we may in truth receive a share in the resurrection of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The crowd in Philippi joined in the attack on Paul and Silas, and the magistrates had them stripped and ordered them to be beaten with rods. After inflicting many blows on them, they threw them into prison and instructed the jailer to guard them securely. When he received these instructions, he put them in the innermost cell and secured their feet to a stake. About midnight, while Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God as the prisoners listened, there was suddenly such a severe earthquake that the foundations of the jail shook. All the doors flew open and the chains of all were pulled loose. When the jailer woke up and saw the prison doors wide open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself, thinking that the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted out in a loud voice, "Do no harm to yourself, we are all here." He asked for a light and rushed in, and with trembling with fear, he fell down before Paul and Silas. Then he brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you and your household will be saved." So they spoke the word of the Lord to him and to everyone in his house. He took them in at that hour of the night and bathed their wounds. Then he and all his family were baptized at once. He brought them up into his house and provided a meal, and with his household rejoiced at having come to faith in God. The word of the Lord. Your right hand saves me, O Lord. I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. Because of your kindness and your truth, you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
I will send to you the Spirit of truth, says the Lord, He will guide you to all truth.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Now I am going to the one who sent me, and not one of you asked me, 'Where are you going?' But because I told you this, grief has filled your hearts. But I tell you the truth, it is better for you that I go. For if I do not go, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he comes, he will convict the world in regard to sin and righteousness and condemnation. Sin because they do not believe in me, righteousness because I am going to the Father and you will no longer see me, condemnation because the ruler of this world has been condemned." The Gospel of the Lord. We will be commemorating and celebrating the ascension of the Lord into heaven in a couple days. And the Lord says in today's gospel that it is necessary that he goes to his Father, because then he will be able to send the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, upon his church. And thus, his apostles, his disciples, will be able to bear witness to the gospel, to the one true faith, to the Lord Jesus, to the truth and salvation, God's plan for humanity. So we need the strength of the Holy Spirit to bear witness. Yesterday, we heard that the Lord said to them that they will bear witness to him and that they will suffer because of the testimony that they will share with the world about Jesus Christ. And they will, and he said that even those who killed you would think they are pleasing God. Imagine how the persecution that the church will endure. And that's what we see, for example, in today's reading, that in fact the apostles are persecuted, mistreated, and they receive all kind of inflictions, all kind of mistreatment. We see here in today's gospel, the crowd in Philippi joined in the attack on Paul and Silas, and the magistrates had them stripped, just as Jesus was stripped of his garments. They were stripped, and the magistrates ordered them to be beaten with rods. They were so sore that thanks to the conversion of the jailer, he bathed them. He bathed their wounds, and they kind of healed a little bit after that violent mistreatment. So we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit to witness to the gospel, to Christ, to the faith, to the truth. Without the Holy Spirit, we cannot become missionaries. And it is an essential part of being Catholics to be missionaries, to spread the gospel, to live out the gospel with boldness. But we need the Holy Spirit. We need the Advocate. And we need the Advocate because the Lord wants us to be his instruments of his salvation. And he will take care of us, just as he took care of Paul and Silas. We saw in the first reading that the Lord didn't only save the life of Paul and Silas, but also that man who was about to kill himself, the jailer. And after what he saw, and after listening to Paul, he said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" Through our testimony of life, others might ask us, "Hey, what must I do to be saved?" But before that, we have to suffer and bear witness to Christ. But I repeat, without the Holy Spirit, it's not possible. And then the Lord says something kind of mysterious. Huh? Mysterious because I think it's not easy to understand at once. He says, "And when he comes, the Holy Spirit, he will convict the world in regard to sin and righteousness and condemnation. Sin because they do not believe in me. Righteousness because I am going to the Father and you will no longer see me. Condemnation because the ruler of this world has been condemned." So the Holy Spirit will bear witness to sin because the world has not believed in Jesus Christ. That is to say, the Holy Spirit is going to show to the world, to the disciples of Christ, that indeed Christ is the Son of God, the Savior of the world. But they will not believe. So it is the same Holy Spirit who will bear witness to their unbelief. The Holy Spirit shares in the exercise that Christ has to judge the world. And then, righteousness because I'm going to the Father and you will no longer see me. The Holy Spirit will bear witness that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that he's risen, that he's glorious, that he's victorious over death and sin, that he is at that right side of the Father. That's what the Holy Spirit is going to witness about. And then he says, condemnation because the ruler of the world has been condemned. That is to say, the Holy Spirit will bear witness that the evil one has been defeated, that the evil one has no longer power over the Son, the sons and daughters of God. Through our way of life, that sin has no power over us, that we can conquer sin easily because of the power that Jesus Christ has bestowed upon us through his Holy Spirit, through that we are actually transformed, that we're actually saved and justified because the Holy Spirit dwells in us. Of course, we can reject the action of the Holy Spirit, but indeed we have the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Christ. So, very important lessons that we see here in today's gospel. Let us not let our hearts be filled with grief, because the Lord has not abandoned his church. Despite all the bad things that are going on in the church, we're not alone. It is his church. It is his boat. The Holy Spirit is with the Church of Christ. The Holy Spirit guides the church to fulfill her mission to bear witness to Christ before the world. The church will be persecuted, but we will receive the strength that comes from the Holy Spirit to endure the persecution. Look at the so many martyrs. Look at the so many saints in the history of the church. The Holy Spirit has done his work, and the church has always won the battle. The church has been inflicted so many blows throughout the history, so many blows. But the Lord has saved his church just as he saved Paul and Silas. And the Lord, through the testimony of the church, continues to save so many people, like the jailer, who are asking to be baptized, who are asking to be to change of life, who are asking the church, "What must I do to be saved?" And it is the Holy Spirit who will exercise judgment along with the Lord Jesus Christ on the last day about the unbelief of the world, about those who have rejected Jesus Christ and the gospel and the church, because the Holy Spirit was working with the church in her missionary
in her missionary work to bear witness to the truth and the gospel. Let us pray in silence. Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the church, the world, and for one another. That many may rejoice at coming to faith in God through the ministry and the living witness of his holy ministers. We pray for the Holy Father and the bishops in communion with him, for unity in the Catholic Church, especially for the church in Germany. Let us pray to the Lord. That God may build up strength within all those who work for the cause of justice and of peace in our world, that their light may shine brilliantly before all. We pray for the end of the culture of death, for conversion of politicians and civil leaders. Let us pray to the Lord. For the coming of the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, into the Church and into the hearts of each of us, to energize and enlighten us with his power and grace. Let us pray to the Lord. That all who call upon the name of the Lord in their suffering of body and soul may experience the Lord's salvation in their lives. We pray especially for the sake of our parish community. Let us pray to the Lord. For our departed ones, especially Charles and Mary Kinmonth, that they may be purified quickly and come to sing God's praises in the presence of the angels in heaven, let us pray to the Lord. And I want to pray also especially for the bishops in the United States, that as they meet soon to discuss important things, they may be enlightened by the Holy Spirit and do God's will always and put God first and the gospel above their feelings and any political or social pressure. Let us pray to the Lord. God of heaven and earth, listen graciously to the prayers that we, your children, present to you, trusting in your divine mercy. In the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you through the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you through the divine work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord,
the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have a those worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Together, that Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead, and so enter into his glory. Alleluia. Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Regina Celi, letare, alleluia. Quia quem meruisti portare, alleluia. Resurrexit, sicut dixit, alleluia. Ora pro nobis Deum, alleluia.